People, welcome. Let's see how to make amazing photo effects with Adobe Photoshop CC. If you are in distress, watch the tutorial videos in this show. Let's suppose to have a general photo. There are many and many of photo effects. We will see here just the main important ones. There are two ways to add effects. You can use the adjustment layers or the camera raw filter. The second one sounds better to make photo effects, but there are some effects that can be made using adjustment layers only. Let's add a color filter to the image. This is like applying to the image a color with some transparency. In the camera raw window, go to split toning and play with the hue and saturation bars for both highlights and shadows. Hue sets the color to add, saturation how much strong this must be. Assure to put the same hue to both highlights and shadows if you want a uniform color filter. Let's now make a photo black and white. This is easier if made with the adjustment layers instead. Simply click on black and white. The image under such layer will lose all colors. In particular, through the adjustment layer window, you can set the lightness of each of the six main colors. In addition with the black and white effect, you can use the invert one to switch up black with white and vice versa. Let's see a special old photo effect. In this case, open the camera raw filter. In the basic section, put the minimum value for highlights and contrast. Increase at max both shadows and clarity. Then reduce a little exposure. If the image looks a little dark and poor, you are in the right way. Now, go in the split toning section and set the color. It should be a light brown one, depending on how it looks like. Then add some vignetting in the effect section. If you are not satisfied, you can go to detail section and add some noise using noise reduction. The post-crop vignetting can be used to add vignetting to photos. Let's see the matte effect. To do this, you just need an adjustment layer called curves. Then simply define a curve where you decrease a little highlights and increase a little the shadows. So simply put the curve higher on the left and more lower on the right of the graph. How about a vintage effect? This is cool in case you want to show a photo a little older than it actually is. Open the camera raw filter and put more exposure and less contrast. Then set colors in the split toning section. Put a warm color for the highlights and a cool one for the shadows. Click the color of the saturation bar to check which color you are going to add. Let's see how to add some gradient. Open the camera raw filter. On top you have different buttons. The first one from the right is the radial gradient and the second one is the linear gradient. They have different shapes, but they basically work the same. Choose the linear gradient and click and drag on your photo to add one. Two points will appear. The green one sets the side where the effects, described on the right, are active. Using the bars, you can set the right settings needed. The side indicated by the red point is the original photo. The length between the two points indicates the length of the total gradient. The longer it is, the smoother it will be. To create another gradient, simply click on New on the right. The non-selected linear gradients will have gray points on the preview, but mine they will stay active. To delete the layer, simply right-click on a point and go to Delete. The radial filter is described through a unique point. If it's red, all outside the elliptical area will be affected. You can invert its behavior clicking on Inside in Effects at the bottom. The gradients can be edited fully. Click and drag the dashed lines to place them in another way. In the radial gradients, click and drag on the squares to set the sides. Approach the dashed lines to rotate. You can move the points dragging them. You can use the radial gradients to start a custom vignetting. Simply click on the rectangle frame besides color. Let's see how to turn your photo into a picture, for example made with watercolors. Open the camera raw filter. In basic section, put the maximum level for contrast. Then go to details section and put the maximum for luminance in noise reduction. If you are not happy, you can decrease clarity in the basic section to set how many details you want. If you want to give a pastel effect, put contrast at -100, clarity and vibrance at +100, and in detail section put the maximum amount and detail for the sharpening. Set then the saturation in the basic section the way you like most. These are just a few photo effects you can add. In the filter section, you don't have to do with the camera raw only. Try the filter gallery to set other artistical effects. Choose oil paint to transform your photo into an oil painting. Whereas you can use a liquify window to distort your image in many ways, using the tools on the left. This is all. I hope you enjoyed this video. Check the other videos in this show if you want to discover more about Adobe Photoshop CC. Thanks for watching.